Hello and welcome to Noni Yanga's flagship talk show where we discuss all the hot topics. Today we ask, as university tuition fees get higher and internships and apprenticeships are more available than ever before, is university worth it? Joining me today, social media manager at our very own Yanga, Ayo Maurice, university student Nima Kotchu, and Cambridge graduate Precious Oyelade. Hello, ladies. I've got some very smart ladies with me today. University tuition fees are at a record high of £9,250 per year in student debt and around £40,000 per student. So is university worth it? Now, ladies, I'm a mother of three girls, and I must say I want them to all go to university. Precious, are you surprised that there are some people that are still like that? Still, you know, in a very creative kind of world we live in where you can make it if you don't go to university. Some parents feel like that still is the only route to success.
Yeah. No, I'm not surprised at all. I think university has always been seen as a safety net. It's something, if you have a degree, then you can fall back on that and it gives you some form of job security. There are a lot of jobs in today's society where you need to be a graduate of university in order to do that. There are many jobs that also haven't been created yet that you don't need a degree for, but that doesn't mean that there isn't that traditional understanding of what it means to have a degree equaling a better income for your life. So as a parent, it makes perfect sense.
Nima, you are at Imperial, still studying. Was there ever an option of not going to uni? Did you ever think, or was it ever a discussion you could have with your parents where you're kind of like, I want a gap year, or I may not even want to go?
I mean, I think that, especially for me, like my parents were always university driven. For me, that was a straight forward
course. No other option.
No other option, yeah. You go to uni, you come out and you get a job. And also for what I wanted to study, there wasn't really a way to get to where I wanted to be without going to university and doing traditional studies. So no, it wasn't gap year. I wanted to do, but my parents shut that down really quick, you know.
They were like, that's a no go.
Yeah, maybe after university, I'll take a year out just to, you know, enjoy myself and have a rest. But for now, it's still uni.
Ayo, is this a surprise? You know, you're a familiar face of the channel, so hello, by the way.
Hi,
but do you think, because for me, I was the first person in my family to go to university. Mm. So in lots of the discussions we had, you know, researching this topic, some people were surprised at that and they were like, no, it's a standard thing to go to university. Was that for you? And can you understand there are some people that university is still a dream?
I mean, I was the firstborn, so I think I was a piggy bank, so, I mean, not a piggy bank, a guinea pig. So my parents didn't really know what to do. So it's kind of like, okay, you finished college, university next. And I think as well, it's kind of my environment as well, because all of my friends, we finished college and we just want to go to uni after. It wasn't like it was a pressure from my parents. I feel like it was a pressure from the society and community, because you just go primary school, secondary school, college, university, that's just
wow.
It. So yeah.
You just knew that that was a route that you had to
yeah.
take. Precious, you went to Cambridge. And I must say, you know, a round of applause for you, because mm-hmm. for a young black woman to go to, you know, an elite university, which it is, you know, is very few and far between. It's just a yeah. very tiny percentage of people that go there. Was there a lot of pressure on you going to that university? And did you ever feel that, you know, you didn't fit in? Or was you, or did you kind of go there thinking, God, I'm going to have the best job when I leave, you know, because I'm going to one of the best institutions, not in the UK, in the world?
Well, when I think about getting into Cambridge University and wanting to leave home, I think the first thing I thought about was, I get to leave home, I get to leave London
okay.
and live by myself. Then the reality of where I was going hit me, because you see it in the headlines today that, you know, Oxbridge as a whole is not very diverse, it's very middle class. And getting there and recognising myself as someone who wasn't from a particularly affluent background, being amongst essentially these old institutions that scream wealth, I found it quite difficult, firstly, to fit in, and secondly, to find people who were like me, because there were a lot of international students who were from backgrounds not necessarily similar to mine. But then I also found people who essentially we were able to unite in our struggle against, because essentially all of us were smart, right? We all achieved the grades that we needed to be there, but that didn't necessarily help us feel like we could fit in. Mm. Because even when you're talking about doing things with certain societies, there's money that you have to pay to do that.
Yeah.
And having that in addition to knowing that you have so much student debt coming up behind you, you're really careful with your time and,
yes.
and what you do. And it's hard to think, what extracurriculars can I do, when actually you're like, I need to do well academically because my whole community is
so
thinking
there was,
about
there,
me.
There was a lot of pressure
yeah.
on you. Nima, do you feel that pressure to do well and achieve well? Or are you thinking, you're still very young, 19?
Yeah.
Gosh,
yeah.
you're a baby.
Yeah.
But are you thinking, I must do well? Or are you thinking, these are the jobs that I want to, you know, attain after uni?
It's a bit of both. I mean, you have the parent side. I mean, I'm in my first year, so my parents still check up on me regularly and still like ask me how
they're
it's
going. They're watching now.
Yeah, they're still watching. I'm in London, you know, I go to uni in London, I live here all my life. So they kind of like get to see me more often than if I was somewhere else in the country. So they're able to kind of see and check on that I'm still like studying properly and everything. So there's a pressure from them. But also, yeah, like you're around people that are smart and you feel, you realize that you're amongst many people who want to do the same thing as you later on. So you have to actually like,
yeah,
work towards being, you know, in staying like above water in your class. And that's a bit of a tough thing to do.
And it's staying above water, not necessarily to get the grades, but to achieve after uni, because you realize that actually everyone in my class wants that job. Let me ask, is it worth it? Is it worth it? We talk about, you know, there are some academic, lessons that you have to do to get a certain job, but you're in the creative industry, you're in media. Do you think your degree has got you your job?
I think my degree has got me life skills,
okay,
and people skills and how to work in the environment. I studied law and I studied journalism.
Wow.
So that's two completely different fields of obviously studying. Journalism was the more creative route, and that's obviously why I'm in this industry, because it's creative, and law was just kind of like, read, you write, everything. So I feel like I've learned in terms of how to balance, because they're two different types of
studies. Yeah.
Like I said, journalism is all fun, you know, film this, edit that, do this. Law, read 20,000 words, write this essay, everything. So it was boring, but I learned how to kind of balance them together, not get too sucked into the fun, and know how to deal with the serious stuff. So when I'm in a new working environment, it is fun, but I still have to work. So,
what about, because you're out and about a lot, what about on the scene that you're out, you know, if you're going to a concert or you're going to an event, your peers that you're seeing around you working for other channels, do you think they've got degrees? Do you think that that law, that studying that law, do you think that's going to help you capture an event?
No, law, to me personally, I just feel like, okay, I've got a law degree. I just know stuff about law, and I don't, it's not like I don't care about it, but it's just to the back of me, but I have that law degree. Everything I love is about media and journalism, so I think that has helped me in my events where I go, because obviously I know how to work behind the camera, I know how to work in a big team, I know how to work with people. So I think the media side has helped me more to work outside and to work in these events. I think with just the law, it's just kind of like, yeah, she's fun, she's, you know, whatever, but she's smart, she knows her law, she knows her degree. So I think that's how it is right now.
Precious, are you working in the industry that you studied?
No, so I studied politics, psychology and sociology, and now I'm a media marketing manager for an academic programs provider. And I think the thing that my degree taught me was a few things. Time management, as you were saying, life skills is what it gives you, but also if you turn around and say to someone, I have a degree and it's of this grade, then it tells them number, like a couple of things, that you can sit down, you can study, you can analyze information.
Just about.
But also that you can disseminate that information in a way that is coherent to other people, because I did an essay based subject. And I think it's about what it says about you rather than what your actual degree is.
Really
that
interesting.
University does.
Interesting point. Well, still to come, we ask our panel, is there a certain gravitas if you can say you've got a degree and why? See you after the break. Welcome back to Noni. In 2016, the Institute of Fiscal Studies published research on graduate earnings. They found that the top earning undergraduates came from the London School of Economics and Oxbridge. So what is more important, the course you choose or the university you study at? I kind of feel like it's the university you study at. Nima, what do you think?
I think that's a big part of it, but it depends what you want to go into at the end of the day also, right? So you can come out of a really good uni and not necessarily want to go into what you studied in the first place. And in that case, university, like, they don't really mind. But say you want to do something like in financial industry, then they really look at where you come from.
Yeah.
But I feel like also parents put a lot of pressure for their kids to go to unis that have big names. But sometimes
get in, because of course, you know, if you're an ethnic minority, you're really unlikely to get in, you know, unless you know how to go through the system and, you know, take the right test and practice for those tests. So even if your mother or father have, you know, high hopes for you, the statistics tell us that there are not enough minority ethnics getting into these top universities, right?
Yeah, I know, I really agree. And also you can ask the question, maybe sometimes it's because they don't feel like they'd fit in, or if they don't feel like they'd even have a chance of getting living and so they won't even try to get in the first place. But then it's partly that kind of like sort of propels the whole stereotype of people not being able to get in if you're their ethnic minority. And the university itself is blamed for that. But then we have to look at maybe it's a two-way street and people have to work in that
too. Of course. Precious, what about you know, apprenticeships and internships? Obviously, you've gone to a very academic institution. But what's your opinion on that? And what's the kind of Oxbridge opinion on apprenticeships? Is that something they kind of look their nose down at, or are they accepted?
They definitely don't, because the reason that a lot of people get internships at the end of their first year or their second year is because they went to Cambridge University or Oxford University. You know, you use that name in order to get into the most prestigious internships.
So you do know it opens doors.
It definitely opens doors for you, because as I was saying, it's that reputation that comes with it that says, you know, you're a hard worker or you're particularly intelligent. But at the end of the day, if you get into that internship and you don't do well, you don't do well. I think that a
really?
Lot of people...
Even if you've got a famous surname?
Even... Well, that's different. And I think that's the difference between going to a prestigious uni and being from a particular family.
Yeah.
Those are two different things in a classist society whereby it really is name, but family name is more important than institutional name, which is trying to diversify a lot more and not necessarily doing that well.
Let me ask you a quick question before I go to Nima. Is everybody in Cambridge smart? Do you think that everybody who was there purely because, you know, they were getting A stars and A's at A level? Or do you think there is a kind of class war and system involved in who's selected, honestly?
I can't say that I didn't hear rumours of particular people having parents at who worked in particular places, who had relationships with certain colleges that meant that they got straight in. But at the same time, I think there are a lot of people who lacked common sense at my university because they were actually in academic clouds, you know, they weren't thinking about normal life. But at the same time, I think people had a particular way of thinking, and that doesn't necessarily mean that they got their A star in their exam, because at Cambridge there's a thing called the pool whereby you may miss your grades, but if you performed well at interview because you know how to articulate yourself, you know how to show how you think, then actually doing badly in an exam on one day isn't the be-all
and end-all. Yeah, and I agree with that. Nima, so do you think that having a degree is going to get you a job?
That's the hope, I guess. Like, you can, it's easy to say that because obviously I don't know what lies ahead when you come out of university. And having heard that, the fact is that you can come out with a great degree, a great grade, and still not manage to get a job. Yeah. So I don't know. Like, right now, I think the best thing is just to try to get as many internships and sort of get experience in the field before you come out. You have contacts and network, and you can start with a sort of a head start already when you come out. But I'm not sure. I hope so. And studying in a field that kind of like maybe lacks women or is sort of like blowing up and stuff is quite like an interesting thing, because I hope that there'll be more opportunities there.
I think you're going to get a great job, and I'll probably be asking you for a job. Now, arguably, industries such as law, medicine and finance require a degree and level of training at university, and so a degree is a necessity. But in the creative industries such as TV and media, should uni be skipped altogether? Precious, you went to Cambridge. If your daughter or son says, "Mum, I just don't want to go to university. I don't see the point. I want to, you know, be a TV host." Is that acceptable for you?
For me, having struggled through 3 years and having done well, like I can't say I didn't do well, but also having seen friends struggle through, I realised that university isn't for everyone. Okay. You shouldn't have to put yourself through that if actually what your pursuits are not academic. I think there's a lot of, from the background that I'm from, a lot of financial pressure, a lot of community pressure, and also it's not every day write essays. Mm-hmm. If you know that you want to speak on a television screen, you're better off getting experience.
Nima, do you agree with that?
Yeah, I totally agree, especially because, as you said, the media, TV industries, like, why should you have to go sit down and pay the money? Because it's not cheap going to uni. You can accumulate debt easily and stuff when you can actually just go get some jobs, get experience, and then get to know the industry, get a head start from those who actually come out of uni.
You're in your first year going into your second year, right? Throughout this, you know, the past 9 months, have you ever thought, what am I doing? Am I doing the right thing? I'm not enjoying this process.
Yes.
I know Mum and Dad are watching.
I gotta be careful what I say now. Basically, yeah, because I mean, I love what I'm studying. I love my like topic, but the thing is that when you, like, the stress is a lot, especially exams, and I don't particularly like deal well with the stress of exams and anxiety and stuff. So I had
none
times
of us
like
do
that.
Well with stress.
Nah, I don't think anybody. Yeah, I mean, you have people who do just like get on with it and stuff, and, but like just it's very, very like kind of traumatizing sometimes. And then you have to realize that a lot of it's going to be hard work, and you might come out not even wanting to do what you studied
yeah,
the whole time.
Of course, and that's what we've seen in loads of cases. Aya, you said you're the eldest in your family. I know you have younger sisters. If they come to you and they say, do you know what? You know, there's this great gig that's going, you know, it's 6 months or it's 12 months, and you know, I can miss out on the first year of uni. What kind of advice would you give them?
It's funny because my younger sister's going through that ooh, right now. She's and it's so funny.
Let's be careful about what my we advise her.
And it's funny because my parents have got a different approach now. They're saying to my sister, if you don't want to go to uni, it's fine, but make sure whatever what you want to do is practical, is something that you can actually do. So she's sitting there thinking whether she wants to do internships or apprenticeships. And I'm like, listen, uni can't come and kill me, and it's not going to kill you
absolutely
either. So you better just do what you need to do that will help yeah you in what you need to do. Because she saw the stress that me and my sister went through. And I told her, I don't want you to go through what I went through. So if you don't want to go to uni, but you've got another option that's going to help you pave the way for what you want to do, then just do it.
Okay, we go back 4 years. Would you do it again?
I'll do it for the fun. Because, you know, I've met a lot of my closest friends.
And that's what a lot of people
here
say. Yeah. When we were researching this, you know, we were in the back office talking about it and we all had different opinions. A lot of people said, that's where I met my best friends.
Yeah,
you know, I've had the best nights, the worst mornings,
yeah,
you know, but just a great, turn up.
You know, the thing is, it's your freedom. We've lived with our family in a big house, brothers, sisters. That's your first step. You've left your house. You're in a different environment, not in London. You meet all the nice guys, all the girls, all of this. You're turning up. You're like, what? And then you have no curfew, no nothing. Mm. It's an enjoyable
so
place.
So it's a life experience, isn't it? But do you think, though, Precious, we have to be careful about labelling university as a life experience? Because actually, you know, this is your first step into the real world. And if you don't take it seriously, you could come out penniless, you know, and in debt, but you don't have a job to even, you know, enter.
Yeah, I think the debt is definitely something to be borne in mind. But the reality is I grew up at university and actually studying the
you think you
that
did.
I did. Well, I think I did. And then
no,
I came out
joking.
And I learned more life lessons. But having the time to do the extracurriculars is how I found out what I wanted to do. Could I have done that on a gap year? Probably, but I didn't. And so actually having that space to do other things was where I really found out, you know, what I wanted to do.
Yeah, and
I
exactly
enjoyed
who you are. Do you know what, Nima? What's your opinion on this? I kind of feel like sometimes people may be a bit naive in thinking that, you know, it doesn't matter if they've got a degree. It's on the CV. They never looked at it. I think employers do. What do you think?
I mean, I think they do. I hope they do.
May not mention it to you,
yeah,
but they know. So if you've been to Oxbridge, you're going to get that call. You know, if you haven't been to Oxbridge, they may see that, okay, she's gone to a university. I don't need to mention it, but I can see she's got a 2-1 or a first.
Yeah. No, definitely. And I think that also, like, hopefully, because you better make it worth it, you know, it better be worth all the struggle, all the work you put in. And if you get a good grade, I think it makes you stand out, but it's just the first step, you know. That's like, okay, they have that. Now, next, onto what they're like as a person, onto how I see them as an, like when they interview with me, onto like different life skills they have. Are they like organized? Are they hardworking? Everything like that. That doesn't show itself from the uni. It does sometimes, but not always.
Yeah.
So it's hard. You can't just take that and assume it's the whole person. You have to take into account other things too, I think.
No, of course. But what about those 3 years, IO, that somebody hasn't gone to uni? You know, they're earning all the money, still living at home, because most of them are. Do you think that's a value that you just can't get if you've gone to university?
I don't know. I mean, good to them. If you didn't go to uni, you got what you needed to do, that's fine. But I mean, everyone's experience is different. It could be a good value going to uni and getting the degree and doing what you want to do, and it could be a good value not going to uni and doing an apprenticeship and doing whatever you want and getting the job you want. So I think everyone's story is different, everyone's path is different, so there isn't really a direct answer to that.
No, of course. Yeah. And all of our paths are different. I feel like on this platform, especially speaking on Noni, I kind of feel like it's important that we encourage young black children to go to university. And, you know, again, you know, off screen, we're having lots of discussions about this. And I wanted to find out, you know, how many black British students are actually going on to university. And I know the numbers are climbing, but they're still not high enough. Some people still feel pressures that it's just not for them. It's too hard to attain. They can't afford it. Their parents, you know, are relying on their second income, you know, to look after their little brothers and sisters. So they just can't go. Do you think, you know, young black people need to be encouraged to study and further their education?
I think they need to be encouraged to know what they want to do, because I think there are so many ways that you can have earning potential now without going to university, that if you're going to go, then it's important that you know what you're going to do, simply because we cannot cut ourselves out of certain areas of society because we don't go to university. We are capable of so many things. Therefore, we should go to university, but we should also go into the creative industries, and we should also go into entrepreneurship. I think we need to do more to ensure that wherever we are going into, we are excellent.
Not just in an academic
way. Not just academically, but
could you
everywhere.
Have got your job, Precious, if you didn't go to uni?
I don't know, because I created a lot of relationships with the people that I worked with before I got my job. And so whether that's because
because whilst you were at Cambridge.
Whilst I was at Cambridge.
So people, you know, me and Aya would never have got to meet.
Yes, very true. And so, yeah, I mean, I will never say that my university degree didn't help me, but also I think there is so much in knowing who you are and knowing how to articulate yourself. And I think you can learn that on the grind if you haven't gone to university, but I will never say that it didn't help me because I went to university.
This is a really great discussion. It's been interesting, and maybe we'll do it again where we have someone who hasn't been to uni, because it's interesting that everyone who's going to uni is saying, don't go, don't go.
I'm not saying don't go, but I have friends who dropped out and who are fine and who are doing well. And maybe, you know, you could say that because they had the grit to get into university, they also have the grit to do well without it. I don't know that many people that didn't go to university at all.
Well, that's it from me, Juliana Olayinka, and my fantastic guests, Aya Maurice, Neiman Kotchu, and Precious Oyelade. And don't forget, Nonny's now online. Wherever you go in the world, go to www.yangatv.com to check out every single episode. Join me next time for more Nonny Chat. Goodbye.